Welcome back to Five Things. Today, we're going to talk about five ways you can build mobile apps with JavaScript. And I've got my awesome guest today, Todd.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm Todd.
Cool. Thing number one, responsive, I hear about it. Reflexive, retroactive.
You know, acronyms, we like to have our acronyms. Responsive Web Design.
How about redaptive?
Redaptive. Don't know redaptive yet. I'm willing to learn a new acronym, but
okay.
Responsive Web Design. So this is sort of the way when we were trying to evolve from Web 1.0, where we built everything for basically desktop screens, say, hey, you know what? Screens are big, they're small, they're long, they're short. Maybe we should make our web apps fit those screens better. And so we said, well, let's just make them responsive, respond to different screen sizes. So that's one of the ways you can use JavaScript and web technologies to build for the web. Just take your desktop site, just make it look better in a different size screen.
Is this something everybody should be doing for all the apps or just for certain types?
Absolutely, this is an evolution of the web. So if you're not making it responsive now, you're a little behind the curve. Every site should be elastic and trying to look as good as it can in any size screen that hits it. So
great.
Should be responsive.
All right, thing number two. We hear about these pois things. What's a pois?
A pois and a wid and spa. You know, we like our WAS and our spas and our acronyms. Progressive Web App.
PWA.
PWA, yes, for the pois fans at home.
I think we're coining a new phrase here.
You know, I don't know if it's going to catch on, but we can try.
So.
Fletch is another thing, right? So PWA is a new term that describes basically just new web standards. And the standards that really make PWA do the hard work is Service Worker and Web App Manifest. And those two things are really, at the end of the day, all about making the web work offline. So this kind of a crazy concept. The internet's the internet. You should be online. You should be connected. But now we're saying, hey, devices move about. They're disconnected from the internet. Sometimes bandwidth is not so great. What if we could give developers the ability to cache things aggressively and even serve things from that cache as they need to when the internet's slow or not there? And progressive web app technologies, Service Workers, and Manifest are all about giving developers that power.
So web apps that work in lo-fi, or
sure.
No-fi.
Or no-fi, yes.
Or, of course, with Wi-Fi.
Or Wi-Fi, yes. Any of the above technologies.
Anyway, but that's really important these days because we're here at a conference and you got a phone. You might have to have connection all the time, or it might be poor.
That's right. That's right.
Gotta make it work.
It's another way to build mobile apps with JavaScript.
Sweet.
SWA.
Number three, hybrid. There's native, there's web, there's PWA, there's all these different kinds of things. Is hybrid still a thing?
Absolutely. Hybrid, so where do these things live on a spectrum? We have PWAs, which is still just a way of doing things in the web browser. It's contained to the limits of the web and web standards.
Mm-hmm.
You have native apps and you have these JavaScript-driven native apps that give you more access to native technologies using native UI. And you have hybrid in the middle there, which is still using web technologies, just living in a native app shell with plugins that can go beyond the limits of the standard web container. So it's like PWAs if you need more access to native device capabilities, but you still want to have HTML as the front end of your app. So still a place for a hybrid. There are new options on either end of the spectrum with PWAs and new ways of building native apps that maybe reduce the use cases for hybrid, but still a valid approach for some apps.
And what are some of the recommended hybrid solutions out there?
Clearly the most popular, Cordova, Apache Cordova, also known as PhoneGap. That's by far the most popular way of doing hybrid apps. So anybody looking to do a hybrid should start there for sure.
Okay, thanks. Number four, there's these other things on that spectrum, like NativeScript and React Native.
Right, yeah. So on the other end there, from hybrid apps, we have this new category of JavaScript-driven native apps. And so here, the big difference from hybrid is we're throwing out the web view where the whole app lives, and we're actually using native UI, just like a raw native app that you built with Objective-C, Swift, Java. Mm-hmm. So now you get all the performance of real native UI, but you can still drive that application using your web skills. JavaScript, Angular, Vue, React, whatever your preferred framework is, maybe just vanilla JavaScript if you don't
like
the
frameworks.
You have
access to all the APIs on the phone.
Access to all the APIs with all the performance. So it's taking web skills and really accelerating the kinds of apps that they can create, giving extra horsepower compared to a hybrid. So it's a new category. And I think it's actually a pretty great way to build mobile apps.
And React Native, obviously you can use React-style syntax. And
right.
NativeScript,
NativeScript integrates deeply with Angular and Vue, so it's kind of an easy choice. If you're a React developer, go React Native. If you're Angular Vue, check out NativeScript, and that's really the way to go.
All right. Number five, wherever you build these on that spectrum, PWAs, hybrid,
responsive,
NativeScript, any of these things.
Yes.
Pois.
Yes.
For pois. Whatever you do, you still need to have back-end technology most of the time, and you don't have a server on the phone. So if you need fast access to data, what are you doing?
That's right. Really, when we talk about building mobile apps, we talk about all these different techniques, that's just half the story, if half the story. A big part of building apps is the back-end piece of this. And as the cloud has evolved and we have all these new options, we've also evolved how we can build, maintain, and scale backends. And one of the nice ways to do this now is actually with serverless functions. It allows us to eliminate a lot of the other headaches associated with standing up and scaling server-side code and just focus on writing JavaScript in the cloud that will scale as our apps need it to.
So is that how you roll, Todd?
I'm rolling that direction. I'm getting rid of the servers. I'm going serverless, cloud, cutting ties to the old ways. But certainly, I think it's the way everyone will go in the future, because who wants to worry about scaling
infrastructure
servers
and infrastructure? Servers. I heard a great expression the other day about serverless. It's not that you don't have servers, that you think about servers less.
Less. Oh, yes. That's an appropriate way of summarizing that.
I like that.
I like that. Good job.
It wasn't mine. I won't take credit for it.
All right. You'll take pois as your credit.
I'll take pois.
All right.
And you can take Redaptive.
Well, all right.
Thanks for coming to this episode of Five Things. And Todd, thank you.
I'm glad I could be here.
All right.
Five.